The successes and failures of Jacques Cartier on his journey to Canada and the relationship he had with the First Nations people. In 1524, France joined the search for a route to Asia. The French had thought that Central America and Newfoundland were islands in the archipelago. Because of this, King Francis sent Giovanni Vernazio to look for routes to China. While Vernazio was on his voyage, he discovered that North America was actually a single continent. 10 years later, King Francis became more intrigued in North America. Francis then hired Jacques Cartier to find out if this was indeed a passage to China. In 1534, Cartier had sailed past Newfoundland and into the Gulf of St. Lawrence, where he then found the Haudenosaunee people. Despite their presence, he claimed all the new territories for France. Cartier then sailed back to France with two young men he had kidnapped. Their names were Taganogani and Domagaya, sons of Chief Donnacona. A second voyage. While in France, Taganogani and Domagaya learned to speak French, and they told Cartier and Francis of a wonderful land full of gorgeous clothes and jewels, of gold, named the Kingdom of Saigone. Anywho, Cartier brought the sons back home a year later in 1535, expecting them to guide him as he explored the St. Lawrence River. Although they agreed, they probably only did it for the trading possibilities with the French. Cartier only had dinky caravels, which made the journey dangerous, with the cliffs of barren rock looming above them like a concerned parent over a troubled child. The awful landscape eventually became trees, forests, and villages, full of open land as they arrived in Stradagana, where present-day Quebec City would be. Ignoring Donnacona's advice, Cartier left Stadagana for a bigger town farther up, the St. Lawrence, named Hochelagada. Donnacona was probably angry because he wanted to trade with the French. Well, in Hochelaga, Cartier was a pretty popular guy, although he and his men didn't want to eat food prepared for them, which was considered very rude in the Haudenosaunee culture. They stayed for less than a day and took off to climb Mount Royal. At the top, he saw land endlessly stretching out to the west and was left less confident that he could reach China via the St. Lawrence. It was much colder in the winter than the French had expected, and the relations with the Haudenosaunee were poor. After 25 soldiers died of scurvy, Domagaya showed Cartier how to make tea that would prevent such eruptions. Despite this and other kind acts, Cartier kidnapped Domagaya and Taganogani again, as well as Donnacona and 7 others, and took them to France forever. King Francis thought Cartier's travels would lead to good things for the French, so he approved a third go in 1541. A nobleman named Jean-Francis de la Roche de Roberval was allowed to begin colonizing in what would now be Canada. Cartier named Canada Kanata, meaning village or settlement in the Huron-Icarus language. In the spring of 1542, Cartier loaded his ships with almost as many diamonds and gold pieces as Roberval had names, and set out for the Gulf of St. Lawrence, where Roberval waited. Going against orders, Cartier ditched and headed for home, leaving the inexperienced Roberval alone, and 50 of his men died. By then, the Haudenosaunee refused to trade with the French and threatened war, so the French bailed. The diamonds and gold proved to be quartz and iron pyrite, and in one swift kick to the gluteus maximus, the French were down for the count. They had failed to colonize North America.